critics. I'm Antoine. Okay, so it's the weekend. I know Black Panther's out, Wakanda Forever. I will get a review for that up. I did not have time to go this morning because the movie's like 3 hours long. It's like 2 hours and 40 minutes, and I got to go to work. So I'm going to do it this weekend, but right now I was going to check out this John Wick trailer. John Wick Chapter 4. Now, we saw the teaser. This is the actual trailer. Now, I know it came out yesterday. Meant to do it yesterday, but guess what? Had to go to work. So anyway, I'm going to check out this John Wick Chapter 4 trailer, give a little discussion about that. I don't know when it's coming. I think it's coming out early next year. So I'm going to give a little discussion about that. And tell you what I think about the John Wick moving forward. You never thought this movie would get up to 4, because the first one was just pretty much a dumb action movie, and it just kept growing and growing and turned to something else. So anyway, let me check out this John Wick Chapter 4, and then see what we got. All right, John Wick Chapter 4.
Same goodbyes?
Saying hello.
You think your wife can hear you?
No.
And why bother?
Maybe I'm wrong.
You're going to die.
Maybe not.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend.
A new day is dawning. New ideas, new rules, new management.
We've known each other since we were 19.
Who is this?
The Marquis de Gramont.
Challenge him to single combat. Win or lose, it's a way out. I don't sit at the table.
Your family does.
Please pray for me. I was the black sheep of the family.
Man has to look his best when it's time to get married. Or buried.
I'm going to need a gun.
Goodbye, my friend. It's hard to
If you win, the table will honor its word. You'll have your freedom.
Under the old laws, only one can survive. Failure to meet at sunrise will result in execution.
Last words, Winston?
Just have fun out there.
There we are.
I want you to find your peace. But a good death only comes after a good life.
You and I left a good life behind a long time ago, my friend.
Let's start together.
John Wick. Somebody please get this man a gun. All right, so that's John Wick Chapter 4. As usual, the action looks phenomenal, so ain't no problems there. The storyline looks good. I mean, the thing was, it always was a simple story, and they expanded the story, which I did like in every movie. They expand the world where these assassins come from. What is this? It's like a society of assassins. Like, it seemed like everybody assassins are who they kill, because everybody is an assassin. It's like, so I guess they're kind of like an underground society that normal people don't know about or whatever. Now they're going to get more into this high table. High table is like the people that's in charge of all the assassins or whatever. And was that the third one? With the one with Halle Berry with the dogs. I believe that's the third one, which that was actually some good stuff, though, the stuff with the dogs. But they expanded it saying that The High Table had an issue specifically with John Wick. So the first one, it was just a revenge flick. Dude killed his dog that his wife gave him. He was just trying to get that one guy back. And then the second one, that's where they started spanning that world where it had something to do with one of the high-ranking members had had something personal against John. So then we got expanded. So now he's wanted for breaking some rules, and he's been taking out a lot of they guys. That's kind of how the High Table got more involved in taking John out in 3. And now John, the way 3 ended, if I can recall, the way 3 ended, John Wick is going to come to the High Table. Basically, I guess he's going to decide to take the war to them or something like that. But it didn't look like that. It looked like somebody else taking leadership. So maybe somebody took them out before he could, and now he's going to challenge them for leadership or something like that. And let's talk about that villain in there. He don't look that scary. He looks kind of like a little corporate dude or something. Like a little dude at an IT company or something. Like, if that's him, hold on, let me see. I mean, we got Donnie Yen. I'm thinking Donnie Yen is just his main enforcer. There he is. You know what? And that's Bill Skarsgård, which he's been doing a lot of stuff lately. And I'm thinking, like, okay, is he supposed to be the main boss? And he's good. He's actually, you would call him a character actor, but you'll say, because he played Pennywise and It, and he just kind of played different characters. His brother is more the leading man, but I think he played more interesting characters, because he got his brother Alexander Skarsgård. It's like, you know, taller, and, you know, let's just say he got more of the leading man looks. But Bill Skarsgård been doing some interesting stuff. But in this movie here, he just seemed to be like he looked like a douchebag. Like, he just looked like one of them rich guys that just, I'm better than you and all that. So I'm guessing that's what's going to be the deal. But the way they kind of make this trailer look like I don't know if I heard that right, but saying that he had to fight John for leadership or something, which I don't think it worked like that. But given the way he looked, I don't see how bad he could. He don't look that tough. Like, after seeing John go through, mold through people for 3 movies, I don't see this guy as a threat. So what are we doing? So we do got Donnie Yen in here. But he seems to be, as they always do, just the main enforcer to the main villain or whatever. Like, they had my boy Mark Dacascos in 3. His name was Zero. He was basically like a monk or something. And a lot of people, you might not remember the name, but you know him. Anybody that like martial art movies would know that guy, Mark Dacascos. So he was his main villain and main enforcer in 3. And 2, I guess Common was the main enforcer. So it's always a main tough guy that's not the main villain. He just equal to John in skills, and John can always edge out the win. So, I mean, we're going to see some more of that. I would like to see something different on that, because that's kind of been the formula they did for 3 movies in a row. So you got Donnie Yen. Are you just going to kill him off like you killed off every other good enforcer in every movie? So I like them to do something different with that. But these movies, you know, what can you ask for? Just enjoy the action. That's how they kind of sell John Wick. Just enjoy the action. But by building a world, though, they have been making it exciting, but no, it is already exciting. They've been making it more interesting. They've been making it more interesting to see where the story goes by, you know, showing the High Table and, you know, all the different factions they got with this world of assassins, the gold coins, the Continental, where the hotel is where the assassins, nobody could kill nobody in the hotel or the consequences would be dire. You see in the first movie, I think somebody broke the rules And they just like four dudes walked up to her and just shot her. Like, yeah, you broke the rules. Oh, yeah, I was trying to get this bounty. Yeah, well, sorry. The penalty is death. And they just like shot her at the same time. It was messed up. It's like, damn, ain't no amount of money worth breaking those rules. So it was good. I heard they was going to make a show about the Continental, which is kind of cool. It can be like an anthology show about different assassins, which, you know, they won't be doing nothing in that hotel, but we can follow different characters in this same universe. That'll be pretty cool. Because John Wick, it ain't much to him. Keanu Reeves, he plays John Wick. That is the most simple man you. He's man of a few words. You could say a whole paragraph to him. He'll just say, "Yeah, okay, no problem." Just like that's all he'll say. You won't get much of a rebuttal from John Wick. He's very stoic. It's cool. I mean, he's a man of action, not a man of words. So, John Wick 4, man, looks dope as the rest. I want to see where that story going to go, and I'm really anxious to see the Continental. I'm guessing it's an anthology series about all the assassins in all the hotels. I mean, I'm sorry, all the assassins in that Continental Hotel. So, can't wait to see that. So, you will get a review. It's coming out in March. So, be on the lookout for that review. So, remember, subscribe to the channel so you can get those and hit the bell icon so you get those alerts. So when I put those reviews up, then you can get them. And you can listen to them. And you can hit thumbs ups. And you can do all that stuff. All right, I'm going to be out of here. Thanks for checking me out. Peace.